SIM and TGA are agar deeps. These media are prepared with agar, but there is less agar in the medium to allow free movement of motile bacteria throughout the tube. The bottom of the medium is called the butt. These two media are inoculated with an inoculation needle. There are purple inoculation needles included in your box. The tube should be labeled with the name of the medium, but they are easily distinguished because SIM is more solid than TGA. Avoid shaking the tubes vigorously so as not to mix in a lot of oxygen. With an inoculation needle, touch a colony on an MSAT plate. Remove the cap of the tube with the pinky of your dominant hand and keep the cap there. Do not place the cap on your workbench to avoid contamination. Working quickly, stick the inoculation needle down the center of the tube all the way to the bottom. This is called stab the butt. Pull the needle straight out when you're done. The best way to inoculate SIM and TGA is to put the needle in the tube, hover over the surface of the medium, centering the needle, and then quickly stab the butt and pull the needle out. Discard the needle in the trash and incubate the medium for up to 2 days and read the results. SIM is actually differential for three biochemical tests. The S stands for sulfur, the I for indole, and the M for motility. Some bacteria can use sulfur as the final electron acceptor during anaerobic respiration. When it takes up these electrons, sulfur is reduced to form hydrogen sulfide, which is a gas, a stinky gas. It smells like rotten eggs. The sulfur dioxide reacts with iron in the medium, which forms a black solid. In chemistry, this is called a precipitate, a solid that settles on the bottom of the tube. If you see a black precipitate in the tube, the bacteria can reduce sulfur. This is reported as sulfur positive. If there is no black precipitate, the bacteria are sulfur negative. Some bacteria have an enzyme called tryptophanase with which they can break down the amino acid tryptophan and produce indole as end product. To detect indole, a special reagent called COVAX reagent is required. Your box does not have COVAX reagent, so you will skip this test, but you should know it exists and how we would test for it. After incubation of the SIM tube, a few drops of the COVAX reagent is added to the tube. If a bright red ring appears at the top of the tube, the bacteria are indole positive. If there is no color change in about a minute or so, the bacteria are indole negative. Lastly, we can see if the bacteria are motile. Because the agar concentration in the SIM tube is quite low, motile bacteria can move freely throughout the medium. When you inoculated the tube, you introduced bacteria in a thin line down the center of the SIM tube. After incubation, hold the tube up to the light to see the stab line. If the line looks clean, the bacteria are non-motile. If you can see bacterial growth radiating outward from the stab line, the bacteria are motile. The results of the SIM test are reported in the order sulfur, indole, motility. These are three independent differential tests, so it's possible to have negative bacteria. Those that cannot reduce sulfur, do not produce indole, and are non-motile. But all combinations are possible. Positive, 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 or negative, positive, negative, or negative, negative, positive. You get the idea. In your case, you should put a question mark in the center since you will not be using indole. TGA or thioglycolate agar is a reducing medium, which means in this case that oxygen is removed from the medium. The top of the medium is exposed to the air, so there will be oxygen there, but the deeper you go into the medium, the less oxygen there will be. At the bottom, there will be very little, if any, oxygen. This is a differential test that allows you to determine if the bacteria are capable of using oxygen and if they are harmed by the presence of too much oxygen. Obligate aerobes can only grow near the top of the tube. That means they grow in the presence of oxygen and are not harmed by a lot of oxygen. They have certain enzymes that react with excess oxygen. In fact, they require the presence of oxygen to grow. Microaerophiles do require oxygen to grow, but they are harmed by the presence of too much oxygen. They do not have protective enzymes like the obligate aerobes. If there is not enough oxygen, these bacteria cannot grow. But if there is too much oxygen, they cannot grow either. You will see microaerophiles grow in a band somewhere in the middle of the tube where the oxygen concentration is just right. Both obligate aerobes and microaerophiles use only aerobic respiration for their energy production. This should bring back happy memories of chapters 3 and 4 on metabolism and microbial growth. Obligate anaerobes cannot use oxygen and are harmed by the presence of oxygen. They can only grow near the bottom of the tube. They can either use fermentation or anaerobic respiration, although only fermentation occurs in TGA. Facultative anaerobes can grow both with or without oxygen. Without oxygen, they use fermentation or anaerobic respiration. However, if there is oxygen present, they will use aerobic respiration. This produces more ATP than fermentation or anaerobic respiration. These bacteria can grow throughout the TGA tube, but they grow faster near the top where there is oxygen present. Lastly, aerotolerant anaerobes are bacteria that do not use oxygen for their metabolism. They use either fermentation or anaerobic respiration, or both, for their growth. Interestingly, these bacteria are not harmed by oxygen. Therefore, they grow equally well with or without oxygen. These bacteria will grow evenly throughout the tube.